Hello everyone, in this video I am going to explain you about shear stresses in beams. So I am going to derive an expression, nothing but a shear force. I will show you the, so tau equal to F into A into Y bar by I into B. So we are going to derive this expression. I am considering a beam which is simply supported acting UDL. I am taking two sections AB and CD, and the length of length between these two sections is DX, and this is one moment. While we apply load, a simple bending, this is one moment at section AB, and another moment M plus DM, and sigma is the stress, and here sigma plus D sigma is another stress. So I'm drawing the same section here. Okay, after cutting the beam it looks like this. So this is the neutral axis, this dotted line. So from this neutral axis to, I'm considering one strip element, like an element which is an elemental cylindrical shape. So from this neutral axis to this cylinder, the distance is y, and from the neutral axis to this section, the distance is y1. So here the length of this cylinder is dx, and the bending stress is, area is dA, and sigma plus d sigma into dA. Okay, this is the bending stress. Sigma plus d sigma is the bending stress, and dA is the area. So first, I told that I consider two sections and area of the EFGH. This is the area of the EFGH. And next, I told that F is shear force, M is bending moment, F plus DF equal to shear force, M plus DM equal to bending moment. So I is the moment of inertia of the section about neutral axis. After that we have to calculate, I told that I am considering an elemental cylinder. This is an elemental cylinder. I showed you already, this is an elemental cylinder. So area of that elemental cylinder is dA, length is dx, and y is distance of the elemental cylinder from neutral axis, and sigma intensity of the bending stress, and sigma plus d sigma is intensity of the bending stress at section CD, and this is at section AB. And bending stress, we know the bending equation, M by I equal to sigma by y. So by this equation, sigma equal to M by I into y. So when we are considering at section AB bending moment, if bending moment is considering as M, so this is at section AB bending moment we are considering as M, and at section CD bending moment is considering as M plus DM. So sigma equal to M by I into Y if M is the bending moment. At section CD, M plus DM by M plus DM is the bending moment, M plus DM by I into Y. So bending stress is sigma plus D sigma. After that we have to calculate the forces on two ends of the elemental cylinder. So force on end of the elemental cylinder on the section AB. So force on this elemental cylinder, so section AB, this side. So that is stress into area of the elemental cylinder. So stress is sigma and area is dA. So M by I into Y into dA, because sigma equal to M by I into Y. And similarly at section CD we have to find out sigma plus DM d sigma into dA. So sigma is sigma plus dm d sigma equal to M plus dm by I. We know the equation, already we calculated here. Next, these two forces are unbalanced forces. That's why these two forces are acting in a opposite direction. I'm subtracting this, if I consider this as second equation and this is the first equation, I'm subtracting 2 minus 1 because unbalanced force. So by integrating this equation, I'll get the total unbalanced force dm by I into A into Y bar, because integral y into dA is A into Y bar. A is nothing but area of the EFGH. I'll show you in the diagram. Y is the EFGH and y is the neutral axis to this distance of the elemental cylinder, center of gravity. Okay, next, shear resistance. tau equal to dm by I into a into y bar. So tau is nothing but intensity of the horizontal shear, and b equal to width of the beam at level EF, area on which tau is acting as b into dx. So nothing but b into dx. Here this is dx and this is b, area of nothing but b into dx. Shear force due to tau equal to shear stress into shear area. So I got this equation. Again I am equating these two equations. Ultimately I got tau equal to f into ay bar into I into b. Okay, sometimes a into y bar is also known as a moment of area about neutral axis. I hope you understood this. So this is shear stresses in beams. Thank you so much. Thanks for watching.